Hello friends, welcome back. Hearty welcome to you. In this session, let us look at this problem related to arithmetic progression. Find the sum of all 3-digit numbers which leave remainder 2 when divided by 5. We have options. Option A 98,910, B 9,820, C 9,830 and D 9,840. What we need to find out is sum of all 3-digit numbers which leave remainder 2 when divided by 5. Now we can solve this problem in two ways. One, we will find out which option is correct without actually finding out the sum, and in that we will not be using any formulas. And in the second method, we will actually apply the formulas and will try to find out whether the sum is equal to which of the options. Now let's go to the first method. In the first method, we will not find out the sum, but we will try to understand based on the options given to us which one is correct. Now if we look at the options carefully, we see that the only option 1 or option A is more than 10,000, remaining all are less than 10,000. If I am able to understand that the sum will be greater than 10,000, I can directly go ahead and put option A as the correct answer for this specific question I am talking about. Okay, now how I can prove that option A is correct? Let's understand that. For that, how the numbers will look like if they leave remainder 2 when divided by 5? Let us say 1-digit numbers, they will be 2 and 7. 2-digit numbers, they will be 12. And if they are starting with 3-digit numbers, the first 3-digit number will be 102 and the first 4-digit number will be 1002. Now what will be the greatest digits? 2-digit numbers, it will be 102 minus 5, 97. In 3-digit numbers, the maximum number we can go is 1002 minus 5, that is divided by 5, so minus 5, that is 997. So if you are able to understand the pattern, we can very clearly see how we can easily find out the starting number and the ending number. Now we are interested in 3-digit numbers, that means we know the first number is 102 and the last number is 997. Now let us see approximately how many numbers will be there between 102 and 997 divisible by 5. Approximately, let us subtract them. 997 minus 102, 895 divided by 5. So I will say that approximately there are 180. I don't know, approximately there are 180 numbers, around 180 numbers. And you can also see that these numbers are increasing in value. That means the starting value is 100, so the numbers values will be increasing. Even I take them as each number equal to 100 also, 100 into 180 will be 18,000. 18,000 is certainly greater than remaining all options. So that means my option A is correct. Let me repeat that again. Now the numbers, 3-digit numbers which leave remainder 2 when divided by 5, starting number is 102 and the last number, 3-digit number, or the greatest 3-digit number is 997. Now how many numbers are there which are divisible by 5 between 102 and 997 and which leave a remainder 2 as we need? Approximately there are around 180. We can easily find out that. We can subtract and we can divide by 5. Approximately we can find out 180. Now we know that all these numbers are increasing in value. That means their value should be certainly greater than 180 into first number value. That is 18,000. And there is only one option here which is greater than 18,000. Remaining all are less than 10,000. That means our option A is the correct option. Now let us see how we can solve this problem using descriptive method, using the formulas. Okay, we know A1 equal to 102. We know AN equals to 997. We need to find out first how many values are there, N. Then we have to find out SN. For SN, our formula will be N by 2 into A plus L or A plus AN. Now once we know N, you can directly go ahead and substitute A equal to 102, AN equals to 997, and we have to just substitute N value. To find out N value, what we will do, we will apply the formula AN equals to A plus N minus 1 into D. an equals to a plus n minus 1 into d. Now, what is an? 997. 997 equal to 102 plus n minus 1 into common difference, which is equal to 5. Because they are divisible by 5, so we have to go on add 5. Now, simplify this, we will have 895 equal to n minus 1 into 5. Or we will have n minus 1 equal to 179 or n equal to 180. So we can come back here and substitute 180. We will have 90 into 1009, and 1009 into 9 is 9891. You have to add one more zero. So that will be 98910, which is option A.